Yes, halo. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Aku dengar.
Salam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Suara saya yang gitu. Screen-nya bisa dilihat nggak? Kelihatan nggak screen-nya? Oke. Okay. Nah. Oops. Oke. Okay. How's everyone doing? Jadi hari ini silahkan dibuka, diklik PPT yang saya kirim kemarin sore ya. Nanti akan muncul tampilannya seperti ini yang saya share di screen. Sudah buka atau belum? Coba lihat dulu. Oke. Okay. So yang sudah bisa buka PPT-nya silakan ditandain. How are you feeling today? Saying today I'm feeling great. Jadi saya klik yang hijau. Kalian juga bisa langsung kerjakan di ini kalian, di smartphone kalian, di HP-nya juga bisa langsung dikerjain di situ. Oke. Okay. So this is how the things today yang akan kita kerjakan hari ini adalah aktivitasnya hari ini adalah the reason why I send you this slide because I expect you guys are able to participate in the live teaching process. Jadi kalian saya buat slide ini biar kalian juga bisa langsung kerjain tugasnya di slide. Gitu. Makanya saya mau kalian akses slide-nya agar kalian bisa langsung kerjain tugas-tugas yang ada di situ. Nanti tampilan yang saya tampilin di sini juga sama sesuai dengan tampilan yang kalian lihat di HP kalian kalau kalian buka PPT-nya. Oke? Okay? Well, the topic today is about the formal invitation. Ini adalah chapter yang ketiga, the third chapter of our topics for this semester. Nah, in this formal invitation, you know, we are going to learn about the structure and elements of the invitation, and at the end, it is expected that you guys are able to write and respond for the invitation letter. Now, first of all, let's have the warming up activity. Kita mau warming up dulu nih, biar tahu. Match the words with their definition. Nah, kalau kalian sudah akses di HP-nya, kalian bisa langsung kerjain ini. Bisa pakai yang line atau bisa pakai yang pencil-nya. Kalau pakai line, you can just do it. Like misalnya wedding. Wedding itu definisinya apa? And you can just do it like this. Wedding itu adalah when two people get married. So, just do it that way. Okay? I give you like 30 seconds to do it. Coba dikerjakan 30 detik, nanti saya akan bisa lihat hasilnya di sini. Okay, next, engagement. What is engagement then?
Keterikatan, sir.
Keterikatan. So, what is the definition you can find here, Derry? Definisinya apa yang ada di sini? What do you do? Derry jawab apa?
Wait, sir. Wait.
Engagement is, what is that? I think it's here, right? When it's two people. Sorry, it's supposed to be two. Oops. Yeah. Then this one. You there? When people agree to get married. Tunangan. Engagement juga bisa di sini artinya tunangan. Because we are talking about, somehow we talk about the, you know, the wedding, pernikahan, then we also talk about engagement. So the meaning of engagement there is like tunangan, when people agree to get married. Okay? Cool. Now we have retirement. Retire. Retire is?
Pension, sir.
Pension, yes. So what is the definition here? Definition di sini apa deh?
The working
career. Yes, thank you. Cool. When a person finish their working career. Cool. Pension, retirement. Graduation. It's here, yeah? When someone successfully finish school. And then we also have the anniversary dulu deh. Anniversary, ini biasa sering nih. Kalian yang sering anniversary, and then 1 bulan, and then 2 bulan.
And then on which at important even from the parts.
Yes, thank you Nadra. I know you keep doing the anniversary. Anniversary is a date on which people remember an important event from the past. Ya, jadi peringatan, ya. And then we have the venue. Venue is the place where people something happen, where something happens. And we also have the memorial. Memorial is, what is that? An event to honor someone who is dead. And then the last is RSVP. So please respond. You're going to find a lot of RSVP in the invitation card, whether it's the invitation letter, dalam bentuk wedding, atau undangan yang lainnya. So RSVP means that you have to respond. Perlu respons untuk RSVP-nya. Jadi undangannya harus dibalas. Ya. Okay. Good job. Now, we have this one. So, there are a lot of kinds of the invitation. You have the invitation for birthday party, you have the potluck invitation, you have the wedding invitation, you have the seminar invitation and all. So, what are common things you can find from these samples? Please write, you type here. Nanti di bawah itu ada show. Oops. Di bawah di HP itu ada answer dan you can type here the answer. Kira-kira apa? Number one, dia ada, you can have the date and the time. Apa lagi? You also have the RSVP.
Place.
You also have place. Yes, good. What else now? Well, basically these three things are very essential in, you know, in the invitation. So it should be clear what time, when, and the day, and then the place. Oh yeah? And then the RSVP as well. Next is this one. Now, you have 2 samples of the invitation. The one on your left is a wedding invitation from David and Sophia. From Louis. And Sergio Martin, and then another one, you have invitation from Samira. Now, when we are talking about invitation, you have to be able to decide whether it's a formal invitation and informal invitation. So when you understand about the context and the register, then you are able to write or to use the words or the sentence or the terms, whether it's formal and informal. Jadi belajar, kita juga belajar mengenai formal and informal terms dalam invitation. Nah, coba dilihat untuk yang pertama, ada teks sebelah kiri dan ada dua teks. Yang mana yang formal, yang mana tidak formal. This one is the formal and this one, the email is the informal one, ya. Yang undangan supposed to be formal. Nah, the activity now is that you got this, you know, numbers. Try to put it here. In nomor satu, the informal, the text yang di email. He would like to invite you to blah, blah, blah. Kalau di formal, bahasanya yang mana? Suppose this one, ya kan? Tinggal tarik ini ke sini. Ini berarti. Kalau di formal, di wedding invitation-nya yang formal, dia bilang, David and Sophia Wester request the honor of your presence on the occasion of the marriage. Nah, sedangkan di informal, simply say, we would like to invite you. So those are the different of the sentences that you can use with informal and informal. Gitu. Number two, RSVP. Di sini dia pakai RSVP by 31st of March. Dia minta respon. Responnya itu paling lama tanggal 31 Maret. Nah, what about this one? Di sini apa RSVP-nya? Mengganti kata RSVP.
So, please let me know if you can come.
Yes, cool. Nah, good. Please let me know if you can come. Good. Well, I think we just go with that. We leave it that way. The point is that you guys can identify the sentences whether it's formal and informal in the invitation, yeah? Move to this one. Now, when you talk about the RSVP, why it's important? The RSVP is very important because, well, that is actually a culture. Jadi ada budaya di sana bahwa cateringnya, for example, cateringnya biasanya akan dipesan hanya berdasarkan jumlah orang yang konfirmasi akan datang. That's the reason why the RSVP is important. Jadi kalau kalian tidak balas email atau undangannya dengan RSVP-nya tadi, then you might not. There's no apa sih namanya? Ya mungkin nggak ada tempat, nggak ada place untuk kalian, nggak ada secure tempatnya untuk kalian. That's the reason why the RSVP is very important. Jadi kalau mau ada undangan, dia ada RSVP-nya, then you have to tell them, confirm secepatnya, apakah kalian datang atau tidak. If you confirm you come, then it's good. They will provide a space for you. Mereka akan secure satu tempat, satu place untuk kalian. But if you do not reply the RSVP, tiba-tiba kalian datang, so sorry that you guys have no place at all. Ya gitu. Atau mungkin gak dapat catering misalnya. Gitu. So that's the reason why the RSVP is very important. Jadi si yang undang bisa tahu berapa orang yang datang. Dan bisa siapin sesuai dengan jumlah orang yang datang itu. Oke? Okay? Now, we're doing another one. Wait a second. Nah, here you have like four these are four RSVP. Ini adalah empat contoh respon terhadap RSVP tadi. Jadi respon dari undangannya. Number one, Gabriela and Manu Navarro will be delighted to attend the wedding of Fayah. Berarti si Gabriela and Manolo mau datang. Itu kan? And then dia buat vegetarian meals are requested. Nah, di RSVP, you guys are you guys can request for your catering. If you are vegetarian, then please tell them that you are vegetarian, that we require a vegetarian meal. Tapi kalau misalnya, or maybe if you have allergic and stuff, then you can just tell them. So, in your RSVP, that's the reason why RSVP is also important. Jadi biar yang buat pesta tahu, oh makannya kalian si A, ini sukanya makan, gak bisa makan saus kacang, karena dia ada kacang, for example. Jadi makanannya tidak akan diberikan yang berbau, yang berhubungan, yang ada kacang-kacangnya. If you're vegetarian, then they will provide the vegetarian meals for you. That's why RSVP is very important when you attend such, you know, event. Yeah? And then you have another three. Now, what you're gonna to do now, once you read this for invitation, is that please identify which one is the formal and which one is informal. Jadi kalian hanya perlu menandai di sini. Kalau formal di tick, kalau not informal di cross. Untuk yang pertama, is it formal or informal?
Formal, sir.
Formal ya. We can make it as formal then we take it. Good. Yang kedua, dear Eleni, we are very sad to say that we won't be able to come to your graduation garden party on 9 June because we are moving house that day. We would much rather be celebrating with you than unpacking boxes. This one, I think it's not really formal. Oops. I think this one is not really formal, yeah. This one, I think this one is quite formal. And this one, not really formal. Now, one trick is that when it is about the formal stuff, biasanya kalau formal itu tidak ada contraction. Jadi tidak ada disingkat-singkat. Kayak misalnya dia mau bilang, I will, ya I will. We will, we will. Tapi kalau dia, oops. Tapi kalau dia yang informal, dia ada singkat we will jadi will, I am going to jadinya I'm pakai contraction, I'm going to and stuff. So that's also one of the trick whether you decide the writing is formal and informal. Cool. Now. This one is the sample of invitation. Let's try to understand what's in the invitation. When will Farah and Nail get married? And you can just type yours here. Si Nail and Farah get marriednya kapan? Can you spot the answer there? Here. It's on the 7th of July 2012. Cool. And then where? Where will Farah and Nell have a party after wedding?
Wells Manor. Wells Manor House.
Wells Manor House? It's quite tricky. Be careful. Look at this one. Dia mintanya apa? Where will Farah and Nail have a party after the wedding? Jadi after, setelah weddingnya.
Friendsome.
Yes. He's in the Friendsome Hall Hotel. Cool. And then, by which date must the guest reply to an invitation? By which date? Sampai tanggal berapa?
First May.
Yes, first of May. Cool. And then the last is where will Niall and Faya get married? It's itu baru jawabannya Wells.
Never house.
Gitu. Okay. Cool. Another one. Nah, for this one, I think this is the last slide that we can do. Now, what you're going to do now is try to write the response to Faya and Neil. Coba buat respon. Kalian datang atau tidak datang? Awalnya pakai dear Miss Faya and Mr. Neil. Nah, kemudian kalian buat. Silakan diketik di ininya, di PPT yang kalian buka di HP, bisa diketik langsung di situ. And then di bawah sini ada write a friendly informal response to Faya and Neil's invitation. Nah, these are the reason. You can pick one of the reason here, whether you come or not. Mau datang atau tidak bisa lihat dari sini. Kalau misalnya datang, tell that you are able to attend the wedding ceremony at 2 p.m. If you are able to attend, you say unable to attend the evening reception at Friends Hall. Bisa datang, tapi nggak bisa datang reception-nya yang di Friends Hall. Udah selesai dikerjakan? Alright, this is the end of the meeting today. The whole activities nanti akan saya upload di Schoology. Jadi bisa dilihat kegiatan yang dikerjakan di Schoology dan project yang akan dikerjakan. Untuk invitation letter ini, formal invitation, kita hanya akan ada satu pertemuan. So this the only meeting we have, jadi bisa dikerjakan, because next meeting kita akan masuk ke topik berikutnya. Okay, now once you finish, please circle how you are feeling here. I would feel this one, to circle this one, because I'm feeling okay. And you also can circle yours in your phone. Alright, setelah ini belajar Pai dengan Buti Frija ya. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.